Hard to believe it's Super Bowl time once again. Our baby, unofficial biggest holiday in America is all grown up. What's up? I'm Mike Janella for 80Twelve. Did you know the cost of a 30-second commercial during Super Bowl I would buy you half a second worth of ad time for this year's game? It's not the only difference between the Super Bowl then and now. Back then, of course, the Super Bowl was a battle between two independent leagues, which led to something we couldn't imagine today, two networks broadcasting the game. NBC owned the AFL rights, CBS owned the NFL rights. It's football, so both crushed it. The combined viewership of 51 plus million people may be less than half the total number who watched last year's game, but the combined 79% of all TVs in use at the time watching Super Bowl I is a record no game since has topped. That's a good way Super Bowl I can say it's unlike any other. It's also unique in this way. The only Super Bowl to not sell out. This distinction was blamed on the sky-high ticket prices of $6, $10, and $12, which clocks out to about $42, $71, and $85 today. Mind you, the average ticket for Patriots Seahawks last year ran north of $10,000. To be fair, Super Bowl I didn't have Left Shark for entertainment value, which is the biggest difference between Super Bowl I and 50, everything besides the football. The original halftime show headliner was a trumpeter with two college marching bands. This year, it's Coldplay. Super Bowl I had a 30-minute pregame show. Last year, ESPN dedicated 130 hours of remote coverage from Arizona all week. After Super Bowl I, CBS and NBC both recorded over their game tapes to save money. Today, your commemorative Patriots Blu-ray will cost you $30. Oh, and they're not using a Roman numeral for the first time this year, but you knew that. Enjoy the game from 80Twelve.
Thanks for watching 80Twelve. Make sure to subscribe, leave a comment, and like our videos. No, you have to tap like. You can't swipe right on me.